Let's get into another customization, obviously for e-commerce stores out there, which is the e-commerce tracking functionality within Google Analytics. And there has been a little bit of a development over the past year because Google Analytics has developed a new part of Google Analytics, which is enhanced e-commerce tracking, which is really, really powerful for e-commerce sites. This chapter won't interest everybody because maybe you're not working on an e-commerce site, but it's nonetheless a very good lesson on how you can enrich the data that you get into Google Analytics. And there's some creative minds out there, if you Google out them, like Simo Ahava, who has used the e-commerce tracking functionality to measure the success of his blog. So if you're creative with Google Analytics, you can actually take the features of Google Analytics and use them for your purposes. But now let's get into the e-commerce tracking, which is really about the thank you page. So classic e-commerce tracking in Google Analytics means that somebody goes through your store and at the end, the ultimate goal is to land on the thank you page. And e-commerce tracking does basically the same as goal tracking. It will register a conversion. Now, with e-commerce tracking enabled and installed correctly, you not only be able to see how many people converted, but rather all the information that is attached to that order. So for example, the product name, the products that have been bought, how many of these products have been bought, the price of these products, the SKU number of these products, and then in the bigger picture, how much was the order worth, how much tax needs to be deducted from that, how much shipping costs are involved into the whole order. So you get a complete picture of that conversion. And that can be super useful because you can later do ROI analysis within your account. So for example, if you have AdWords installed, then you could see how much money you spent on AdWords and how much money you made on AdWords. And that just wouldn't be possible with a normal conversion count. You could maybe get the conversion rate, but all the information that lies in how much was spent within the order that the user made isn't really visible. You could go into your shop system and find it out and then reconnect it somehow. But with e-commerce tracking, you really get the capability of attaching that to the outcome metric, to your goal within Google Analytics. Now I will talk about a little bit more about the technical details about this later in this lesson, but it's safe to say that this is again not something that you configure within Google Analytics to pull out the data from your shop system, but rather you capture and send that data on the tracking code level. So you need to have some customizations on this page on your code to send over the right information to Google Analytics. Now you saw that we just attached certain properties to the conversion data that we generate on that thank you page. We can also enhance other features on our page. So enhanced e-commerce tracking is really about the different touch points that we have on an e-commerce site and how we can enhance the data that we collect on this e-commerce site. So for example, on the homepage with enhanced e-commerce tracking capability, you'll be able to track slider clicks, product clicks, promotion clicks, and on all the other templates like the category, product, there are specific kind of tracking mechanisms that you can trigger to send over data to Google Analytics. And this gives you the capability of looking to the data within Google Analytics in a more e-commerce centric way. So for example, you'll be able to see what matters most to you, which are probably the conversions, but also how people navigated through the site and how users or customers behaved on your site. And through the installation of enhanced e-commerce tracking, you'll be able to fill certain reports that make your analysis easier. So for example, you'll get a checkout behavior report. Where did people drop off? How many of these people continued on within the whole funnel of your website, and you can segment down to certain areas of that funnel. You'll be able to have a funnel view throughout different user groups and throughout your whole site. So for example, how many of people who visited the checkout abandoned the checkout later? And you get really good reports about the product performance. So you'll get data about the conversion rate per product, how many people viewed the product, put it into their cart and later bought it, versus those people who just viewed it and didn't buy. And this can give you a really good relation of what product is actually performing better than other products. Now let's take a look at the technical details on how to get this implemented.